Because we have an Ottoman motor car. Very utilitarian, very cleverly designed, because we have the engine and the steering and everything in one place at the front. How clever is that? Do you have any idea how much one of these would have been used? Of course, in the context of the traction trailer, it was very, very conservatively priced.
Yeah, I must be it. Well, I've read that he was trying to get, the man who designed it wanted to get rid of the horse off the front of the car, and this is what he came up with.
Yes, and I mean, I think to a great extent, and he did a wonderful job, didn't he, in market garden terms, in terms of small livestock farms. This was a very, very handy little outfit. Great to see. Thank you for bringing it, sir. Now, the Grey Fergie, the Grey Menace, they were called. A very, very innovative, cleverly made little tractor. Do you know much about the history of this one, sir?
It was 1948, built in Coventry.
Fergie's at the back there.
At least I got the manufacturing
place. You can hear the commentary.
As I say, over 500,000 of these were made. A fantastic example of a very clever British design, because it made the implement integral to the tractor. In other words, the weight of the implement transferred to the tractor, and that then made it a very, very operator-friendly little tractor. They used to demonstrate them at sales promotions with a 12-year-old boy on it. Imagine that today. Great to see, and a nicely presented tractor. Thank you. Now, hello, sir. What have we got here?
1949 TEA-20.
Again, such a successful little tractor. This is what is known as the Little Grey Fergie. Petrol paraffin, I assume? Great petrol. So this might even have been an industrial or something like that. Do you know much about the history of it?
Spent all its time
right next to the microphone here. Speaker, I should say.
Until 10 years ago. Really amazing. Well, great to see him. Thank you very much for bringing it, sir. Now, we talked about Ferguson and we talked about Massey Ferguson. Well, of course, this is what, this is, I assume, Canadian built.
No, it was assembled in Manchester from the chassis, back axle, manufactured in Canada, but the engine is manufactured by Perkins in Peterborough, and the electrics are and the fuel injection is CAV.
Now this engine, Perkins T6, a wonderful engine, with a lovely sound to it, and it was absolutely the making of these tractors, because in Canada they were either petrol or natural
T20
gas.
There, folks.
But by putting that English engine in was a very, very clever piece of design. This tractor is an absolutely stunningly presented tractor. Thank you so much for bringing it, sir. Really wonderful. Now, E27N. E for English, 27 for the horsepower, and N because that was the donation that they gave to tractors. Very nicely presented this, I would say, just after the war. Give me an idea of the age, sir.
51.
51, so we're talking very much in that post-war time where there were a lot of shortages, a lot of rationing, quite difficult to get hold of all these things. But Ford, by adapting the front of the old tractor to the back, which is relatively new, actually made quite a successful tractor and sold many, many hundreds of thousands of them. Do you know much about the history of this one, sir?
Not really. They made about 220,000 or something like that.
Okay.
This one, do you know much of its individual history?
This one from Carterton, Mr. Post at Carterton. He was an uploader.